Hey guys, this is John with Greenfish Nation. I want to welcome you to our channel today. Guys, it's springtime. The fish are in the pre-spawn mode, the spawn mode, and the post-spawn mode. You're going to find fish in all three modes. We're going to be testing out a new rig out here today at the honey hole. It's called the Hanisuko Rig. It came from Japan back in the 80s. We Americans adapted this as the split shot rig. What I've got here is I've got a little weedless hook about 6 inches above it. If you guys can see it there, I got a little split shot sinker, 1/16 of an ounce. In Japan, it's called the Hanisuko rig, and that translates to the booger rig. So you guys stay tuned for some fishing action here on the channel today with Greenfish Nation. We're going to be chunking this booger rig, see what we can do. Got about a 25-mile-an-hour south wind today. Got kind of overcast skies. Water temperature, I just checked it, it's about 58 degrees, depending on where you check it here on the pond. Got a little bump there. Had one on there. Like I said, I'm learning to use this. Don't really know how everything's going to quite feel, so it may take me a minute. I know these fish are up shallow, though, and they are spawning. I'm throwing this on it's called a sprayed grass. It's a 6-inch trick worm. Seems to be a pretty good color wherever you go. Just trying to feel for those subtle bites, which may be hard to do in this wind today. This is a little finesse technique. The Japanese, they tend to be a little ahead of us on finesse stuff. Just kind of dragging that along the bottom. Trying to figure out how to use it. See how everything's gonna feel. And how bites are gonna feel on it, because I'm gonna be taking this technique out to Lake Fork on Wednesday. There's a little bite. I believe he's got it. Ah, broke me off. Well, dadgum. You guys stay tuned. I'm gonna go tie on another booger rig and see if we can't get out there and get back in that one, because that was a pretty good fish. Again, I'm using 8-pound fluorocarbon here, so see how it goes. All right, guys, we're back. I had to go tie on another rig. I think I might have possibly pinched my slip shot or split shot on there a little too tight, and I might have compromised my line. I actually just pinched this one down with my fingers. So let's get back out here and see if we can't get on one. I think that was a pretty good fish we missed, because fought it for just a second, then my line snapped. So big female should be moving up. We're about, I think tomorrow morning at 6:18 is actual full moon, the lunar full moon. So we're within that 3 days ahead and 3 days behind. That 6-day period there, or 7-day period of the full moon, when the spawn's supposed to be at its best. But this, I'm throwing this thing on a weedless hook. I got a little wire weed guard on it. That way I can get up in that cover as best I can. I'm trying to just get right there to the edge because I know those fish are probably going to be sitting in those weeds. I want them to see this thing fall and come out there to it. Pick it up. I'm giving them a little time to run with it. Like I said, I'm just learning to use this thing, so it's all new to me. I'm gonna try a few different things. I may have to slow it down some. I may have to change my action on my rod. All right, guys, we're gonna try to hit some of these little pockets here with this booger rig. Well, guys, I broke off again. Not sure I'm liking this, but we're gonna tie on another one. We'll be right back. Be as apt to kink up and make a weak spot in my line. I think that's what's happening, but anyhow, we're gonna stick with it until we catch a fish or two anyway. Pretty dadgum windy. I think the wind pulled more line off than my cast did. All right, we'll make another cast or two right here. And we'll see if we can go maybe on the other side and hit that ditch over there. This may just be one of those times. Well, had a bite right there. Hey, good news is I didn't break off. My weight squid slid down though. Had a little nibble. Cleaned up here. All right, let's try it again here. All right, we did turn one right there. I seen him pick it up. He ain't no giant, guys, but he's a fish. He fell for the little booger rig. Get this hook out of him. He ain't much, but hey, we're on the board. Well, that's one, guys. Got the skunk off of us. He picked it up right on the edge of that weed line. I don't know how this thing skips. Give it a try there. Lots of mayflies out. Bunch of baby mosquito hawks. There we go. It don't skip as good as a I think I got my drag set right now. Can't hardly even pick the fish up. It don't skip as good as it would if it was weightless, but a little better fish right there, boys and girls. About 2 pounds. Not too bad. Like I said, it don't skip as good as a weightless one would, but I think it'll do all right. Two on the booger rig so far. They shouldn't feel a whole lot of weight when they pick this this thing up, because number one, there's not a whole lot of weight on it. And the hook ain't very heavy. So. Thought that was a fish. Spit it out. I wasn't sure if I drug through some junk or if that was a fish, but sure enough, that's a fish. Hey guys, I want to thank you for joining us today here on Greenfish Nation. Fish the old booger rig, also known as a split shot rig, or Hanisuko rig in Japan. We got broke off on a pretty good fish, pretty much right out of the gate. We broke off twice, we caught two fish, and we got lots of bites on it. I'm just learning how to use this rig, so appreciate your patience with me. Had a great time today. Thank you guys for watching our video. If you haven't subscribed, drop us a subscribe button right down there in that subscribe area. Drop us a comment and tell somebody about us. Give us a little thumbs up. Until next time, I'm John with Greenfish Nation. I want to wish all of you tight lines.